The Battle of Buena Vista, February 22 to February 23, 1847, also known as the Battle of Angostura, saw the United States Army use artillery to repulse the much larger Mexican Army in the Mexican-American War. Buena Vista, a village in the state of Coahuila, is 7 miles, 12 kilometers, south of Saltillo, in Mexico. Background. After the Battle of Monterrey and the end of the armistice, Major General Zachary Taylor's Army of Occupation with General William J. Worth's 1,000 men advanced onto undefended Saltillo on November 16, despite orders to halt any movement further south, considering it strategic to cover the approaches to Monterrey and Pérez de la Fuente. Taylor then directed General John Ewell from Monclova to Pérez, the objective being control of that agricultural area. Will's force moved to Agua Nueva, south of Saltillo, on December 21, to counter rumors of impending attack. In mid-August 1846, Antonio López de Santa Anna returned from exile and quickly assumed command of the Mexican army, abandoning any pretense of reconciling with the U.S. He reached San Luis Potosi on October 8 with a force of 25,000 men. In early January, Santa Anna acquired a letter from General Winfield Scott ordering Worth's troops to join General David E. Twiggs and General John A. Quitman's divisions in Veracruz, prompting Santa Anna to make attack plans for Saltillo. General José de Urra's cavalry would simultaneously retake Ciudad Victoria and cut off Monterrey from Matamoros. Tamaulipas, Santa Anna's army departed San Luis Potosi on Jan 27 with 21,553 men, and reached Encarnacion, south of Saltillo, with 15,142 men on February 20. Taylor moved 4,650 of his men to Agua Nueva on February 14, but on February 20, Major Ben McCulloch's Texas Rangers encountered Santa Anna's force at Encarnacion, prompting Taylor's withdrawal to Angostura, a mile and a quarter south of Hacienda San Juan de la Buena Vista. 1,209 Gen. Wool was charged with selecting the field of battle and making such dispositions of the troops on the arrival of the enemy as he deemed necessary. Wool thought the site excellent for defense since the road passed through a narrow valley here, which was crossed at right angles by several ravines east of the road and arroyos were to the west. Wool placed Captain John M. Washington's battery across the road, supported by the 1st Illinois under Colonel John J. Harton and 2nd Kentucky under Colonel William R. McKee. Continuing to the left was the 2nd Illinois under Colonel William H. Bissell, General Joseph Lane's Indiana Brigade, the Kentucky and Arkansas Horsemen, with two squadrons of dragoons and a company of Texans in reserve. Santa Anna advanced to Carnero Pass below Agua Nueva on February 21 and on February 22, demanded a surrender, to which Taylor's aide, William Wallace Smith Bliss, eloquently replied, "I beg leave to say that I decline acceding to your request." Santa Anna's forces consisted of Major General Manuel Maria Lombardini's division and Major General Francisco Pacheco's division in the center with 14 pieces of artillery, Colonel Santiago Blanco's regiment of engineers and 3 16-pounders on the left, and Major General Pedro de Ampudia light infantry with General Julian Juvera's strong cavalry brigade on the right with 2 batteries. In reserve was Major General José María Ortega's Infantry Division and Brigadier General Francisco Mejia's Brigade. Battle. Santa Anna began the attack with a feint by Mejia to the American right, but his main thrust was to the American left. Wool moved 3 companies of Kentucky cavalry under Col. Marshall and 4 rifle companies of the Arkansas Regiment under Colonel John S. Roan and 4 companies of Hoosiers under Major Willis A. Gorman to strengthen his left. Marshall's and Ampudia's men skirmished by 3:30 p.m. but darkness brought an end to the fighting. After dark, Taylor, escorted by the Mississippi Rifles, Colonel Jefferson Davis, and Charles A. May's dragoons, checked on the Saltillo garrison, but returned by 9 a.m. on the morning of February 23. During the night, Brigadier General Manuel Micheltorena moved 5 8-pounders above the American left, intending to flank them along the high ground the next morning at daylight. Ampudia's brigade started the assault, supported by Lombardini's and Pacheco's divisions, while Mora's demonstrated against the American right. The 2nd Indiana faced a force of 7,000 Mexicans, prompting Wool to send the 2nd Illinois and Captain Thomas W. Sherman's battery in support. The Hoosiers, after taking 90 casualties, broke and fled, forcing the 2d Illinois in a slow fighting withdrawal, and Marshall's men to flee northward to the Buena Vista Hacienda. Cheever's cavalry was able to turn the American left flank and head for Buena Vista. Davis' Mississippians were ordered to shield Buena Vista along with the Arkansas and Kentucky cavalry, the 3d Indiana, and Captain Enoch Steen's dragoons. The American left was thus strengthened, the center still held and the right was still solid. At the Hacienda, Archibald Yell's men held, although he was killed, and Steen's dragoons were able to split Cheever's column, forcing the advance portion past the Hacienda and under fire from Sherman's battery, while the dragoons threw the rest into confusion. Davis' men then sent the Mexicans fleeing, although Davis was wounded in the heel. Major John Monroe organized the defense of the Hacienda proper, using the 2d Indiana, from Cheever's attacks, while the Mississippians and the 3d Indiana were organized into a large V, forced Cheever's about 2,000 survivors into a ravine. A young Mexican lieutenant, Jose Maria Montoya, tricked Taylor into a ceasefire, allowing the trapped Mexicans enough time to escape. Brigadier Jose Vicente Menon appeared before Saltillo but retreated to the southwest. Santa Ana renewed an attack on the main U.S. position led by General Francisco Perez with artillery support. They were met at 5 p.m. by fire from O'Brien's and Thomas guns and 2 Illinois and a Kentucky regiment under Colonel John J. Harton, in which he was killed. An artillery battery under Braxton Bragg then arrived with orders to maintain the position at all costs. 1216 Taylor rode over to Cap. Bragg, and after a brief conversation in which Bragg replied he was using single canister shot, Taylor ordered double shot your guns and give him hell, Bragg. Later this order, although misquoted as give them a little more grape, Captain Bragg, would be used as a campaign slogan which carried Taylor into the White House. Barris's attack was repulsed and the fighting ended as heavy rain fell over the field.